Hey, Miles here, milesbeckler.com, and in this video, I'm gonna share with you the secret that I'm using to get really high relevance scores on my Facebook ads and how to get really good engagement and really good conversions with those ads. I've been building my Facebook ads in a very specific way and incorporating this element that I'm going to explain here in this video with you, and that has resulted in a big time positive shift for my kind of Facebook ads and everything that comes with that. So first and foremost, what is the relevance score of your Facebook ad? Facebook is monitoring how well they think you are doing when it comes to communicating about the topics that the audience is interested in and the audience themselves. So Facebook is looking at the copy that's on your advertisement. They're looking at the kind of group of people or the audience that you're targeting, and then they're also looking at the copy on your landing page. And Facebook's trying to kind of determine, are you hyper relevant? Are you really targeting the right people with the right message that's gonna have a really positive kind of user experience for that Facebook user or not? And how you know what Facebook thinks how good of a job you're doing is, that's your relevance score. It's a number between 1 and 10, and ultimately you need to have this number up at least at a 7 or 8, and I think you need to keep working with this until you see nothing but 9s and 10s. And it was when I realized this and got my relevance scores up to the 9-10 range that I saw my cost per click drop, my cost per lead drop, and my cost per acquisition drop. And what that's a signification of, what the 10 signifies, is that you won the auction, right? Facebook thinks that you are the best advertiser and you have the best message for this audience versus everyone else out there. So if you're sitting on like a 3 or a 4 relevance score, they're going to be charging you more for the same clicks than if I was against you and I had a 9 or a 10 relevance score, because Facebook's trying to motivate you kind of through a negative motivation, through charging you more, to really identify the needs, the challenges, the things of interest to your audience, and then speak directly to that with your ad copy and also the copy on your landing page, right? So how do you get your relevance score up? Well, the biggest kind of shift that I've made is incorporating long copy above the ad image. In a Facebook ad, there's only 3 real places that we get to add text, right? So there's the image, and that's gonna be our kind of like what's above and below. There's the text that's above the image, there's the headline below the image, and then there's that little call to action text. Really, the trick and the key for me has been to write long text ads where the text is all above the image. And what happens when that ad loads for a user, it usually loads 3 to 4 lines and it has a read more button. They click that read more button, it expands, and then it has a read more button again. And then they click that second read more button. It might be learn more, then read more. They click that second link, and then it shows the entire content of the ads. And some of my ads run literally hundreds of words, right? And it's not just like stuffing content in there. There is another step to that, and that's where we're going with this. But the first thing to understand is, when you give Facebook lots and lots of content that talks to your audience about your niche and their problems and the solutions, etc., you're essentially feeding their algorithm a lot of content to work with. Similar to how we play the SEO game on Google, right? When we put lots and lots and lots of content that's really good on our website, Google's able to look through and be like, okay, all this content on this website is about this topic. They're an authority. So we have to apply that kind of idea over to Facebook ads, and you got to really kind of create authoritative style of content. So what type of content? Do you just write like an article? Definitely not. There's a specific type of content that I've been using, and it is crushing it, and that is stories. It's leveraging and using stories in that top part that hook the reader in. Because here's the thing, right? Like, humans have been telling and sharing stories for like tens and hundreds of thousands of years, right? Like, history was storytelling for an extremely long time. Printing press was made in something like the 1400s, right? Like, you can go back and find when the written kind of like written languages came out, and there was such a long period of time up to that point. So our brains are pre-programmed to be able to consume stories, get into stories and visualize them. And when we read stories, if you've ever read a good fiction book, or even if you've ever gotten lost in a great Hollywood movie, you find yourself, you actually go into that story. You feel like you're a part of that world, of that experience, of that character's story, right? You feel emotionally involved with the character. You really buy into it. And that's the feeling we want the user to have on Facebook, right? So what we're doing is we started out with a little bit of a hook. And for me, I'm usually starting, okay, so let me actually give you a bit of a formula to work with. It's essentially the hero's journey formula. And this is something from Joseph Campbell, and it goes way, way back to mythology, and it overlaps with Carl Jung's take on the different archetypes of the different people. And Carl Jung is a like a psychologist, one of the early psychologists. So there's essentially a few different like hero's journeys, right? And they're all stories, all great Hollywood stories, all great books generally follow these same kind of hero journeys stories. Now, I really took this to the next level when I studied story-powered marketing, which is an Andre Chaperone kind of collaboration with Michael Haig. Michael Haig is a screenwriter. Andre Chaperone is a marketer. They did like a 3 or 4 hour webinar together, and that's called Story-Powered Marketing. You could check that out at milesbeckler.com/story, S-T-O-R-Y. I'll have a link pop up here for you. It'll also be in the description. If you want the, and that's a paid product, and I've gone through it repeatedly, and it's been incredibly valuable, but if you don't have the money to invest in a product to get it kind of simmered down to a marketer's take, right? That's why I appreciate that product is Andre. They really break it down for like, how does this apply to marketers? Then I highly recommend reading Joseph Campbell's work. Right? You can get it for free at your local library. The Hero with 1,000 Faces is his most kind of popular book that really talks about this hero's arc or the hero's journey. If you do some Googling around the hero's journey, you'll find a website called The Writer's Journey. And on The Writer's Journey, they analyze this theory of the hero's journey from a few different standpoints. And effectively, the idea and the premise is that if your stories follow this hero's journey kind of formula, right? Like, I hate to use the word formula, but honestly, it is very formulaic. If you follow this formula with your advertisements, when they read the first few lines, if they're hooked, they're gonna click the read more button. When they do that, they get engaged in your story. They get hooked in your story. They end up clicking the next button. They consume your content. And this is a pre-framing tool, right? This offers you a pre-frame for you to really set up the problem, the solution, the story, or the journey in a way that's going to be consumed easily by the reader. It's going to have emotional impact, and it's going to leave them, if they are resonant with what your problem and solution is that you're kind of explaining through the story, they're going to want more. That's when they read the headline. That's when they click the button. That's when they visit your landing page to get your free offer. Now, it's really, really powerful. And the basics of the kind of hero's journey is that you start off with an introduction of someone, and there needs to be some sort of kind of a resonance factor, whether it's humor or it's a potential challenge that they both have experienced, both being the person in the story and the reader. And then, generally speaking, you hit some sort of a challenge, right? The hero's journey, you have some sort of a challenge, you're called to some sort of action, you strive to become more, to overcome that challenge, and then you come up from that low point and you achieve new goals and you overcome challenges all the way on the way up. Now, I have oversimplified that to a ridiculous point, to be honest with you, but you really gotta learn this stuff because, I mean, there's an old adage in sales, right? Like, stories sell, what is it? Statistics tell, facts tell, stories sell, I believe is the actual phrase. I totally got lost there for a second. But it's those who have mastered storytelling, whether it's one-on-one sales, whether it's copywriting, whether it's Andre Chaperone and what he does, whether it's Hollywood producers, people who learn how to tell great stories in an engaging way that follow the formulas that have worked, those hero's journey, those mythological formulas that still work today, those are the people who are converting the most traffic into clicks, the most clicks into subscribers, and the most subscribers into customers. It really is an art. I highly recommend that you engage with this and you read this. If you're currently running Facebook ads, try a split test on an ad where you write a long copy ad on top. I'll link in the description to a video I did where I reviewed some Facebook ads, and most all of them, these successful ads, were all long copy. They didn't all follow the story format. I'm recommending you use that story format because what it's going to do, it's going to trigger your audience in a way that they're already pre-set up to enjoy that type of content through television, books, through kind of the way the brain works, through storytelling over the ages, movies, etc. So I highly recommend you implement long text ads in Facebook. I also highly recommend that you study storytelling. The great part about studying storytelling, it goes so far beyond the ads, your follow-up sequence, your autoresponder sequence, and those emails you send out once they're on your list. Using stories is by far the most powerful way for you to quickly build the relationship, build the trust, get them to where they know, like, trust you, and then that is when they'll click on your links, they'll check out your affiliate things, they'll check out your products, etc., etc. This can also be leveraged for video sales letters and for just written sales letters as well. So study storytelling. If you want, I highly recommend the story-centered marketing from Michael Haig and Andre Chaperone, milesbeckler.com/story. Or if you're on a budget and you want to go down to the local library and get a book out from there instead, The Hero with 1,000 Faces by Joseph Campbell. You're going to have to do a little bit more kind of creative thinking if you go the Joseph Campbell route, right? You're going to have to kind of take what he's talking about and how these stories work, and you're going to have to figure out how to insert them into a digital marketing world. If you want the shortcut, that's where Andre Chaperone's course comes in. And I hope this has been helpful. I hope to hear from you after you test some long text copy on the top of your Facebook ads. And I'd love to hear what your relevance score was before, what your relevance score was after. Once you get to that 8, 9, 10 relevance score, you're going to gobble up the best traffic that Facebook has to offer. You're going to get the best deal on your cost per 1,000 impressions, your cost per click, your cost per lead should go down, and you should see more conversions out the end of your funnel, which is ultimately the goal. I hope you found this video to be helpful. I'm going to put all of the links and all the things I mentioned, they're all going to be in the description. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up here in YouTube. It helps me get the reach out. I do appreciate that. And I look forward to connecting with you on the next video.